सर वेलकम टू आइडिया एक्सचेंज।
यस
सर आप पहले आए हैं यहाँ पे, सो ऑफ कोर्स यू नो द फॉर्मेट। सो लेट मी जस्ट स्टार्ट विद अ क्विक क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट डायरेक्टली, बिकॉज वी हैव अ वी आर शॉर्ट शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम। सर 6 months इनटू द पैंडेमिक, व्हाट डू यू थिंक हैज द गवर्नमेंट्स कम्युनिकेशन बीन लाइक इन दीज 6 months, एंड इज देयर एनी स्कोप फॉर इम्प्रूवमेंट अबाउट इट?
प्राइम मिनिस्टर स्पोक फ्रॉम द हार्ट डायरेक्टली टू द पीपल एंड इट हैज इंपैक्टेड अ लॉट एंड इंडिया मिनिमाइज दीज लॉसेस due to the people's participation on the appeal of prime minister. And I think that the next one difficult challenge also for the winters, he has already talked from the bottom of his heart to the people, and that will also succeed, and India will be in the range with the minimum losses. We will win this war against corona.
So moving on to actually some of the more pressing issues right now, like, you know, a very pressing issue right now, of course, is the issue of TRPs. I have a two-pronged question about that, sir. First, what do you think the government can do to ensure that TRP data is more robust? And second, there's a related question into the current investigation that is happening. Like, BARC is an industry body and Mumbai Police Commissioner came out and, you know, mentioned a few names. Why do you think you as a union minister and the BJP president felt the need to come out and defend one person or an organization, sir?
No. Let me make it very clear that government doesn't take side of anybody, because BARC is an independent institute which both the stakeholders in the industry, that is advertisers and the broadcasters, it is between them, and they have formed this BARC. So to run BARC efficiently is the job of both the stakeholders. Of what happens in BARC, we have not interfered in it. My two representatives, though not as ministry, but as broadcasters of Doordarshan channels, so we participate in BARC proceedings. But other than that, we don't interfere into these affairs. Are you inviting me to interfere?
No, sir. I'm asking, like, you know, you had tweeted about the investigation. The BJP president had also mentioned about the investigation. I was asking about that as well, sir.
No, I am saying it very clearly that repression of press is not welcome. That's the only thing my tweet has given the message. And I have not mentioned any channel or any person.
Okay, so let's move on to the floor first, then we'll come back to more questions.
Yeah,
I'll first ask Liz to ask a question.
Sir, all BJP leaders are, you know, going to Patna and, I mean, going to Bihar for campaigning. You know, one issue we have been hearing right from party president's speeches, you know, and to every leader's speech, that, you know, it's about how Rahul Gandhi or Congress leaders are talking about Pakistan. Why do you think that when the party is claiming that, you know, we have a good governance record, and when Prime Minister's governance record is good, as you claim, then why do the BJP leaders have to, bring in such issues? And every election you are bringing in this nationalism and nationalist issues. When you have as you claim, there is a governance record to put a report card before people.
It is not we that are creating any problem. Congress is creating problem for themselves. Who spoke in Karachi, Lahore? It was Shashi Tharoor. And why Rahul Gandhi tweeted the way he tweeted and discussed about PAC? So when you are talking about 370 or any other thing like Pakistan, that is, if you are speaking the language of Pakistan, this is definitely a point here of reference and of definite reactions. So we are not indulging into, we are not digging up something what they spoke about 10 years ago. We are just reacting on their yesterday's talk, recent their tweets and recent utterances. That is what we are reacting to. And we have a big question, that why you talk Pakistan language on Kashmir?
But sir, you know, last time also when Mr. Amit Shah, then party president, had talked about, like, you know, if BJP loses, there will be firecrackers in Pakistan. You know, the party's own assessment was that it kind of boomerang. So, you know, which means, you know, that is not what people want. Or at least in Bihar, the people did not accept that kind of a campaign last time. So why does BJP again bringing it? You know, what...
That is what I'm saying. That it is
every speech you are bringing it, sir.
Congress is speaking. Rahul Gandhi said that 370, Digvijay Singh said, Chidambaram and Digvijay Singh tweeted and said that 370, we will restore 370. So I challenge them that write this into the Bihar Manifesto of Congress. Now Congress has come out with separate manifesto. I'm eager to see whether that is included in Bihar Manifesto. That is what I challenged. So what is wrong in giving political reaction to a political tweet or political speech?
The next question is from Isha. She covers environment and climate change for us.
Yes.
Namaskar, sir.
Namaste.
Sir, I have two questions. The first is about the EIA draft notification, which received a record number of objections and suggestions. And it was controversial in the sense that there was a lot of criticism about the draft notification. So is the ministry looking at including these recommendations and maybe overhauling the draft completely? And my second question, sir, is that the Ministry of Finance has recommended to the Ministry of Environment to disengage from 5 autonomous bodies, including the Wildlife Institute of India and several others. So what position is the ministry taking on the recommendations?
Which recommendation?
There's a commission in the Ministry of Finance which has recommended that the Ministry of Environment disengage from 5 autonomous bodies.
I'll tell. As far as the EIA draft is concerned, we welcome all suggestions and criticism even. There is no issue. So we have appointed a committee to go into all the suggestions, and we found out that more than 98% are the same wording and same matter which has been there. But we have taken cognizance of everything. And we are what now doing is, we are analyzing those and we'll definitely consider all points raised. But let me tell you that it will take little time because the quantum was large. So it will take little time.
So how much time are you expecting?
We cannot say that 30 days or 40 days like that. But it will take some time. And after that time, we'll announce our decision. That is one. Second is important, very important. And we will also explain to the people what the EIA actually proposes, what was there changed from 2006 to 2014, and what we have just consolidated many of the things which were already done in 2012, 2013. And on many occasions, the previous government has done many things which we have just consolidated as a list. And if that is taken as our decision, that is wrong. That also we are going to explain. But let things come to that stage, then we will discuss with the people, not today. And as far as 5 autonomous institution status is concerned, it's a suggestion. We will be seriously looking into it, and we will be definitely give our opinion to the finance ministry.
Sure, sir. Like, you know, keeping on the topic of the environment, so UP and Haryana, your states, the issue of air pollution has again come up. So what are you planning for Delhi, NCR and the other states? Because the issue comes up every year.
See, basically, acceptance also of a problem is the beginning of solution. In 2015, Prime Minister launched National Air Quality Index. Till that time, there were only manual voluminous data which were available, but there was no one figure of air quality index. Now that index we have provided, and that is the beginning of solution. Now, based on the findings of various towns and cities, we have chopped out a national clean air program for 100 cities. And as you may not have forgotten, that 15th August, Prime Minister said that within 1,000 days or within 3-4 years, we are going to improve the air quality in these 100 cities. That includes NCR region, Delhi. It is special focus because there are special factors also. In Delhi, as you know, we have taken so many steps. I'll just enumerate. First, throughout the country, we have launched BS6 fuel as well as vehicles. This is a most revolutionary steps, and that will reduce vehicular pollution to the extent of 50, 60, 70% on various parameters. That is one. 60,000 vehicles used to pollute Delhi, though they have no work, they had no work in Delhi. They were just passing through and polluting. Now, because of completion of Western Express peripheral way, which was not completed in 10 years, we completed in 4 years, and now no such undesigned vehicle enters Delhi. So that is second thing. Dhaula Kuwa, you have seen, it used to take at least 20 minutes. Now it doesn't take 2 minutes even. So this is how we are improving the all road traffic and congestion spots so that congestion goes away. Then the third is important is Badarpur plant and Sonipat plant. We have closed thermal power plant. More importantly, we have created renewable power throughout the country, 87 gigawatt. It's not a small thing. It's a huge development. And 87 gigawatt of solar power, solar and wind power, which is completely natural and which is pollution free. And we have also laid more than 40 crore LED bulbs, saving tremendous amount of electricity. So the pollution in the end also gets reduced. So this is what we have done in every sector. We have brought in construction and demolition waste management rule for the first time. I saw the metro tunneling work, and we have borrowed the good practices of metro tunneling to the construction demolition waste. That rules were made and framed, and now they are getting implemented. So people are putting the curtains when the construction is on. They put sprinklers, smog guns, many things. And so dust is, because this is alluvial soil. Delhi has a typical geographical or meteorological problem also. Let us not forget it. That we have Himalayan winter, Himalayan cold weather, coupled with dust in the air and the moisture from the Gangetic and rivers bed. So you will find out, if you find this Samir app, if you download Samir app, because it gives a present position of pollution in more than 122 cities. So you will understand that the alluvial soil region, that is Gangetic belt, has the maximum pollution load. And in other provinces, with the same traffic, with the same industries, with the same population load, Mumbai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai don't get this much pollution. So because there are geographical factors also responsible. But central government has taken actions in every field, and therefore even stubble burning, we have given 1400 crore rupees for machines, and many farmers are using machines. And you will find out that ultimately when this year's parali season goes, after 1 month, we will find that we will have reduced, that is what we expect, we will have lesser stubble pollution this year. That is what a scientist are expecting. So let us wait and see. But we have taken action on all fronts. The waste management practices, the water sprinkling mechanism, the dust suppression machines, we have provided to corporations. I started first in 2015, the practice of calling all the 5 state ministers of environment ministers from all the 5 states, which are impacting the air shade of Delhi NCR, that is Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh and Delhi government. And I am already calling all of them every year, one meeting with me, then two meetings, one meeting with principal secretary, one meeting with cabinet secretary, two meetings with our secretary, and then at the respected levels. And CPCB holds many meetings, and task force which is formulated has more than 20 meetings. So continuously we are monitoring the situation and following up with the and reviewing the progress made by each state. And there is some progress done. Electrical push, the electrical vehicles, electrical rickshaws, e-rickshaws, and many other things. Metro, expansion of metro is a tremendous thing. We made it fast than what it was for 10 years. And now more than 5 million people, not in the corona time, but non-corona days, it was 5 million people which used to travel environmental friendly without and avoiding at least 5 lakh cars on the road. So all this addressing industrial pollution, we have already converted nearly 3,000 industries on piped natural gas from furnace oil. We have banned pet coke. We have converted all brick kilns, which are actually closed now. So this year, brick kilns are not working. So pollution is not there from that source. So we are, and now my 50 teams of CPCB are in the field to take stock of the situation every day. And they are reporting me every evening.
So just one more follow-up question, slightly unrelated, of course. So today, free COVID vaccine for Bihar was announced. So will it be state-specific, the vaccines, will it be free or not?
Actually, this question should be asked to Harshvardhan ji, because when vaccine will come, it will come for the whole world. So that is what is happening. So I actually don't know. Harshvardhan will be best able to tell you what the story of it.
Okay, sir. Let me ask now Shivam Patel, who covers Delhi for us. He has a question.
Please.
Hi, sir. Mera question jo hai, wo Delhi NCR pollution ke related hai.
Ji, ji.
Jaise abhi aapne zikr kara ki pollution ka jo issue hai, wo Delhi ka hai, nahin pure airshed ka hai, jo cover NCR cover karta hai.
Ji.
To airshed jo hai, wahan pe matlab hawa ka rukh same rehta hai in region mein. To, but पिछले छह दिन का जो AQI देखा जाए तो दिल्ली का AQI कम है बाकी NCR टाउन के कंपैरिजन में काफी कम और जो ऐसा देखा जाए कि जैसे इस साल DG सेट बैन हुआ है दिल्ली ने तीसरे साल बैन कर दिया है गुड़गांव और नोएडा अभी भी स्ट्रगल कर रहे हैं क्योंकि वहां पे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पूरा प्रोवाइड नहीं होता है CNG जो है CNG बसेस दिल्ली में चलती हैं गुड़गांव नोएडा में नहीं चलती और जो बदरपुर पावर प्लांट है दिल्ली का वो भी बंद हो चुका है बट NCR में है अभी भी पावर प्लांट कोल बेस्ड पावर प्लांट तो सर ऐसा मुझे ऐसा देखने में लग रहा है कि दिल्ली ने काफी स्टेप्स लिए हैं पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल करने में बट बाकी जो NCR टाउन है वो शायद उतने स्टेप्स नहीं ले पा रहे हैं हम दिल्ली
एज यू नो देयर आर सम लोकल इश्यूज बट टुडे ओनली आई एम राइटिंग टू चीफ मिनिस्टर दिल्ली that the electrical buses which we provided, offered from 2017 are not on road even today. The first was lot of 40 buses and then there 400 buses were sanctioned. So I'm writing him the letters with details that please hasten up because they have asked twice permission to finalize the contract and they have asked for extension. So it is actually one should act fast. Many towns have come up with electric buses, but Delhi is yet to have. So there are many issues in Delhi industrial area. So it is not one state versus other state. It is not blame game. It is all together we have to work because the airshed doesn't understand the political boundaries. It doesn't understand even the geographical boundaries. It is one geographical area in the sky which impacts this airshed And that is what we must take into consideration.
So,
what A versus B?
Okay. Sorry, Shivam, we have a lot of questions pending, so I'll move on. So, next question would be from Ashish Aryan. So, he covers telecom for the Express.
Please.
Good afternoon, sir. Under the INB ministry, there's a PSU called BECIL, which is Broadcast Engineering Consultants India Limited. In the past few months, they have come out with various tenders, which are, let's say, controversial to say the least. For example, one tender was on fake news. Now, how do you defend a tender when we have not defined what fake news is? The tender wants to identify the perpetrators of fake news, or even other tenders which want to monitor the social media of users so as to identify certain trends or certain problem makers.
No, actually, I don't know all these tenders which you are talking about. Let me take information, because fact check, we have established PIB's own authentic fact check unit. We take note of complaints or various social media news on our own and get the authentic information, put it on the record, and every day we do fact check and stamp them fake. And that PIB stamp has become authentic.
And but so this is apart from the PIB.
They are regular employees which are doing the job. So my 20 people from PIB are doing the job. That is not a tender or somebody has been outsourced.
No, but this is from apart from the PIB, which of course we all know. This is from BECIL,
I will not talk in absence of my knowledge. I will definitely ask what is the issue, because fact check is done by only one source, that is official source is PIB, and we have employed our own people, so there is no outsourcing.
Okay, sir. Next would be Sir Aditi Raja from Gujarat.
Good afternoon, sir. My question is regarding the seaplane project, the water aerodrome project that is coming up in Gujarat. Now, we reported about it last week about how the government of Gujarat applied for environment clearances only in July, while we are looking at the inaugural run happening on October 31. As per the terms of reference given by the MOEF on 21st September, the Sabarmati terminal of the project does not have any kind of clearance, also the Kevadia project, because the one of the conditions is very clearly stating that they have to see two seasons, one monsoon and non-monsoon. So at this point, would this project, would the start of this project or even the start of the work on these projects not be in violation of the Environment Impact Assessment Notification of 2006?
No, once any proposal is submitted officially, we reply and give our decisions officially. So when that will come, you will understand that what has happened. But more importantly, my question to you all is whether we want new kind of tourism to explore or not. Whether this airplane, because I have seen, it's a no pollution and a very wonderful thing to happen. I was in Canada for a conference, and in Canada where I was staying in a hotel just in front of this, there used to be seaplane landing every 3 minutes and taking off every 3 minutes. So it was a very busy place there. And people were traveling and enjoying as a tourist also or as a passengers also. And so they were serving the nearby areas within the range of 1 hour. So that's a good way, the good instrument to travel differently. And that is why we must promote these kind of facilities. Of course, there are various other precautions which need to be taken. So we will definitely work with Gujarat government in this regard. Seaplane is a very wonderful avenue of not only tourism, but for nearby services also. Within 1 hour, it can go. And it's very, if you want to create an airport, it's a huge expenditure. In rivers or seas, it is no expenditure. It is most environmental friendly. And therefore, I have seen myself when I was in Canada for a conference, in front of my hotel room, there were every 3 minutes, one seaplane was landing, and 3 minutes it was taking off. So it was wonderful.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, I actually wanted to ask about a representation that the power minister had made in August. He said that he'd written to your ministry to extend by 2 years the deadline to install pollution reducing equipment, the FGD systems, for over 300 thermal power units. I just wanted to understand, what is the status of that representation?
The status is that some plants have fixed their, have already FGD installed in their systems, but many projects have just given orders and the orders were disrupted because of Corona. So there will be definitely delay in procuring the machinery. There are some plants which are not even ordered, which are preparing the DPR, and very few are there which have not prepared even the DPR. So there are various stages. We are continuously in dialogue with the industry, but industry was also in recession, as we know, the DISCOM crisis, the power crisis, because oversupply and less demand, and therefore there were issues for these factories also. They have already installed many other technology which saves the emissions from the power plants, and therefore we FGD program, we are considering continuously having dialogue with the industry, and we will work together to ensure that FGD happens in time.
But what sort of extension are you willing to give in this case then?
That depends on case to case basis. Okay. We have already made a review of various, as I told, there are four categories. One is already ordered, has to be installed. Some machine has to come, it is ordered. Somewhere DPR is ready, but orders are not given. And somewhere there are cases where DPR is not ready. In between, there are many ownership change in many power plants has taken place. So that has also added some part of delay, which is actually must be considered positively. And therefore, I'm very sure that Indian industry will be cleaner. And we have already, on thermal plants, we are investing 46,000 crore rupees for new technology called coal to liquid that will reduce pollution to a great extent. That already is on. So on all avenues, we have started taking action, and that will result. Today, absolute coal consumption of America is little more than what India uses.
Okay. So next Thank question you. Is from Nirupama. She is our Mumbai resident editor.
My question is about yesterday, a BJP stalwart in Maharashtra, Eknath Kharse, he left the party, and it is said that he may join the NCP. So did the BJP make enough of an effort to retain him, do you think? And doesn't his departure dent the party in Maharashtra? Or is it that you wanted to make an example out of him, that the party was already dissent? That's one question. The second one is that the BJP has been saying that the Maharashtra ruling coalition is very unstable and it will collapse anytime now. But we are also hearing that just Kharse, but there are others from the BJP who are waiting in the wings to jump ship. So in your assessment, does that indicate an unstable coalition? I mean, I'd like to hear your views on that.
Yeah, as far as Kharse is concerned, he is our senior leader and has worked for the party for 40 years now. But still, there were some problems. And therefore, if he has taken a decision, it is his decision, not forced by party or not because of party, but he has taken his decision. So let us see what happens actually. And second is, as far as many people are waiting in the queue to jump the gun, actually it is the reverse what is happening. But there is a common glue for, see what happened, let us understand this election results properly. Shiv Sena won on Modi's banners, Modi's posters. BJP Shiv Sena got majority. we fought as alliance, and the alliance got 160 seats. So we got complete full majority. We should have been ruling. Instead, Shiv Sena ditched BJP and went with those whom we defeated. That is Congress and NCP. These are the two parties whom we defeated. So Shiv Sena decided to ditch BJP and people actually. They ditched the mandate of the people by Maharashtra to give Narendra Modi a state to fulfill the dreams. And that is what Shiv Sena has ditched. So it is the Shiv Sena which is answerable, not BJP.
So next would be Gopal Kateshia.
Sir, my question relates to Static Lion and Gir Forest.
Yeah.
The railways has submitted a proposal to Gujarat government, forest department, seeking diversion of some 17 hectares of forest land for converting the meter gauge line into broad gauge. This line crosses the Gir Sanctuary. This is Visavadar Talala line, and which goes up to Kodinare. This is also important because of the fact that Shapurji Polanji Group is developing a port in Kodinar. And so it's possible that the traffic might increase on that line. And on the other hand, scientists have been advocating that there must be at least 1,000 square kilometer inviolate area for sustaining the lion population and its further growth. How will your ministry reconcile the needs of the infrastructure development with conservation of wildlife?
Yes, that's a good question, and I will ask you and your other colleagues to visit Penge Forest. I will ask you to go to Penge Forest where we have built the road, double laning. Now it is four laning. So four lane road with quite good number of underpasses and overpasses. And that has resulted in movement of more than 5,000 animals, wild animals in 1 year. So this also is the solution where you can take care of conservation as well as development necessary.
So next question would be Manoj CG. He covers Congress for us, sir.
A Delhi-based journalist from Kerala who works with various Malayalam outlets, his name is Siddhi Kapan. He was arrested when he was on way to Hathras and later booked under UAPA. So as the INB minister, have you tried to speak to the UP government to find out, what prompted them to, impose UAPA on a journalist? Have you spoken to the UP government?
See, we have received information of the case, and you can also ask the government. Government is open. It has submitted and will supply you also information why somebody is arrested. Because in many states, in Maharashtra also, there are many journalists are being arrested. So I thought that you will ask them because that is latest after Hathras. But you chose to ask UP. But originally, we were asking question in Hathras to Congress that you are making noise on Hathras, but you are keeping silence on Bara, not only Bara, but all the 10 places of Rajasthan where worse kind of rape, and the same scheduled caste girl, she was raped in front of her husband, and both were beaten up. And when she went, but there was Lok Sabha poll on 5th. So she went on 24th previous month, and that case was not registered. So this is the cruelty. And this cruelty, and they made it viral. The whole episode, they means the culprits were so, in a way, they were promoted in a way because they could even relay it on video, and still they were very much sure that nothing will happen. And so nothing happened. And so Congress cannot be selectively have a selective amnesia, but they have to condemn all incidences. That's what I said. We condemn all incidences.
Akash Joshi next.
You've already said, and you were right, that the government, whether on the TRP issue on Bollywood, has been impartial. But there is an impression since the Sushant Singh Rajput case that the party, the BJP, has not been that impartial. Bihar means, I think, in September, early in September, first or second week, those posters came up. That 60,000 posters saying, na bhulenge, na bhulne denge. In both on television now and in print, party functionaries, official BJP functionaries, have been both directly and indirectly offering a defense of one of the parties in this case, the defamation case that the big producers in from the Bombay film industry was fine. How do you see that impression? That is that all right to politicize something like this?
Basically, matter is under investigation of three central agencies. People have faith in it. Let them give their final report. Two, as the matter is in court and the agencies will submit their report in the court, any party saying anything doesn't make the difference in judicial system. Judicial system will decide the case on merit of it.
So, but there is a political, of course, judiciary, of course, but there is a political politics here.
Yes, there may be a local reaction of people or voters to a certain case in a certain way, but we have not taken it as one state versus other state or anything. It is the way first inquiry was held, whether it was good or not, people have their own opinion. But let us wait for the final result of the three agencies and then we'll be able to matter.
So next is Shubhajit Roy.
I have a simple question. It's been five and a half months since the border standoff in China began. I would assume in the last 5.5 months, there would be at least 20 cabinet meetings that have taken place. Has the issue been discussed in the cabinet between the ministers? And have you given any suggestions on your ministry's behalf in your capacity as a senior political leader, the senior cabinet minister to prime minister or the senior leadership in the government?
On what?
What should be done on China?
See, China is being closely monitored and China has also understood that India today is not India of pre-2014. It is a change. We have given a fitting response to the situation and as government has made it very clear that we have not succumbed an inch. The Congress has succumbed large parts of tracks on the border earlier, but now things have completely changed. We are well prepared and Security Council Cabinet Committee on Security always keeps track practically every minute, every day and takes appropriate decisions.
Has it been discussed in the cabinet, sir?
No, it is discussed in the Cabinet Committee of Security in which all the cabinet ministers who are the members of the committee are present.
So just a follow-up question from my side. Do you think the government has been clear in its communication about how much land China has encroached during this standoff?
No, not at all.
You mean they have not encroached or what?
Yeah, already government has made it clear not a single inch of Indian land has gone anywhere.
Then what is the standoff all about, sir?
Standoff is about the effort.
Effort meaning, sir?
Effort from Chinese side on the border. So we are also protecting our borders very clearly.
Moving on, since we are still pressed for time, sir, Mallika Joshi from Delhi.
Sir, I wanted to ask about pollution. Like Shivam had earlier spoken about how NCR towns may there are some issues, DG sets ke issues hai, connectivity ke issues hai, traffic issues hai. So Delhi mein sir, like you also spoke about right now, like the focus is largely on Delhi and the NCR towns sort of escape that attention,
no,
but are almost as much at risk and in some cases more at risk in terms of numbers when it comes to it.
Let me explain again.
Yeah.
That airshed doesn't understand the geography.
Exactly, sir. Exactly. That's
so, therefore, sir, we are looking to the whole airshed.
Yeah.
And so, sir, we are not one thing. We are monitoring my 50 teams, which leave early in the morning and return only in the late evening. cover all the Ghaziabad, Noida, Gurgaon, Faridabad, other areas, and Delhi proper. In Delhi, there are 10 agencies which are working. There is NTMC, there is three corporations, there is state government, there is industry department, there is Jal Board, there is DDA, there are so many agencies. We are taking in and we are communicating with each agency every day that this is where the problem is. You please address it immediately.
Sir, I'll ask Isha to ask another question. She has one more question.
Sir, I have actually two small questions. One is, what is, you have committed internationally to move towards clean energy. So what steps have the ministry taken to, are you going to be phasing out coal thermal plants? Because recently the NGT also cleared a plant in Bulandshahar. What is the ministry's position? And the second question, sir, for CAMPA funds, you have said repeatedly that over 47,000 crores has been released by the ministry for afforestation after forests have been diverted. Does the ministry monitor how these funds are being used? Because first of all, a lot of states don't submit their afforestation plans on time. And secondly, there have been reports of saplings either not surviving in the plots where they're planted, or afforestation not really being a success. And therefore, when you divert a forest, you lose that forest forever. No, so
let me tell you, the CAMPA money has already credited to the state CAMPA accounts, but that authority, we have made an arrangement where every year they have to forward, they have put up the annual action plan, and that when approved becomes effective. So we constantly monitor the situation, and we have laid a big principle that the money is essentially for afforestation. So afforestation related activities will have 80% of allocation. Only 20% will be other avenues of forestry, which ultimately helps in afforestation. But there will be 80% money going in for afforestation. As far as you are concerned, we are also monitoring and mandating that all such new plantations will have to be geo-mapped, and the coordinates will have to be communicated. The earlier picture of degraded forest has to be communicated. And from that, we will monitor from satellite monitoring of each plot which is being developed every year on year. And that will be also, we want to put it in the public domain, so people can see alternative forests are growing. A, and what was your first question?
So the ministry's policy on phasing out coal thermal plants.
See, coal thermal power plant, we have already taken decision to make coal cleaner by coal to liquid. And we are emphasizing on our renewables. We want to create 40% of our energy capacity, installed capacity in form of renewable. We have already achieved 87 gigawatts. We will achieve more than 100 gigawatts by 2022, and we are on course to achieve the Paris targets. But as far as doing away with, no country has done away with coal power plants.
I have, sir, just last two questions now.
Yes.
First, a quick one, I'll bring you back to what I asked earlier regarding the manifesto announcement about free COVID vaccine. For people living outside Bihar, will there be free COVID vaccine or not, sir?
No, I don't know where from you have got this Bihar COVID. See, if the vaccine comes, it will be for all the world and the India. It is not one state vaccine. So I really don't know. You will have to ask Harshvardhan.
So if it is free for poll election bound states, it will be free for others as well.
That is different. That party gives manifesto with the intended programs. So that program of government, somebody has to subsidize. If government decides to subsidize, that is a different question.
But sir, if BJP government decides to subsidize in one state, why not the entire nation then?
Then let the vaccine comes. Then every state will help their citizens differently.
Okay. So then last question, going back to the media. So actually the media has been in news for quite some time now, you know, as Akash said, Sushant Singh Rajput case. Then there was a Sudarshan News case as well, in which an IMB ministry created an IMC. So what is the status of the IMC in the Sudarshan News case? And do you think there have to be certain limitations on what media can do and should not do as IMB minister?
See, that is what my question to media is. Now, every day, many high courts are also suggesting that ministry must intervene to stop the rot. Not only in TRP scam, not only in BARC, but even other areas of programming. Many high courts are saying that ministry should take stand. We don't censor. We believe in self-regulation. But whether the self-regulation works or not, Abhi, now only before you were interviewed, two prominent new channels owners had come to me. They want to give me a letter that let government intervene first because to save the industry from bickering and going down. But I told them that it was broadcasters and advertisers. These are the two stakeholders for giving advertisement. Who gets how much is the private thing, nothing to do with the government. And therefore, we never intervene. My two representatives are there not as government, but as broadcasters, because we have so many Doordarshan channels. So they go there as broadcasters. But barring that, we have not intervened in either bar or in our rating system, or even in news channels, programs and serials. There is also a more rising demand on OTT platforms. So that's a topic again open. I called them twice to have a credible self-regulation method, but they have not come with any proposal.
But so like Sudarshan News case, so in that case, what does the ministry stand now?
In which case?
So Sudarshan News.
That is already in the court, and we have given our affidavit, and the interministerial committee has already, I think, interviewed them twice. Now it will submit its report to the court.
The last question, if you allow, then we'll end up.
Yes.
Shivam has one more question that he wants to ask.
Sir, hi. Mera question air pollution ke link ka aur premature ke premature deaths ka hai. जैसे हम अभी पैंडेमिक में हैं, आपने और हर्षवर्धन सर ने पहले पार्लियामेंट में कहा है कि कोई लिंक नहीं है एयर पोल्यूशन का और प्रीमैच्योर डेथ्स का. आईसीएमआर के स्टडीज ने भी लिंक एस्टैब्लिश करा है. अभी पैंडेमिक में भी लंग्स पे इफेक्ट होता है एयर पोल्यूशन का. तो आपने आपका अभी स्टैंड सेम है या
द ऑफिशियल आंसर दैट नो साइंटिफिक स्टडी हैज शोन अस that a direct correlation between pollution and death. But pollution is bad for lungs and everything, that everybody knows it. But that is bad in California also, na? When there is a wildfire, it is bad in California. Sometimes I feel wondered why American universities and other universities study only Indian cities and not study their own backyard.
So ICMR ne bhi kara hai.
Huh?
ICMR ne bhi kara hai.
So ICMR ka study is a different thing. It is under study.
Okay.
Great. Great. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for giving the time and thank you for answering all the questions so candidly.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you, Prakash.